Okay, so the next comes the when somebody has got a liver problem, isn't it? So we know that liver is the main organ which is concerned with the metabolism of carbohydrate, fat, and carbohydrate, fat, and proteins. So it is better if we will come to know what happens to the metabolism of these things, isn't it? So can you please tell us what derangement has happened to the metabolism of protein, fat, and carbohydrates?
In normal function of liver, the liver will metabolize, will be a metabolism of carbohydrate, but protein and fat, and in form of carbohydrates. When the person eats carbohydrates, the liver will take up the carbohydrate and store in the liver in the form of glycogenesis.
So you want to tell us that the liver has got an ability that when there is a excess glucose in the blood, the excess glucose in the blood will be taken up by the liver, and liver will store this glucose, right, in the form of glycogen. And whenever between the meals we need glucose, then this glycogen will be broken down again to glucose and will be supplied to the cells of the body. Yes.
And then if the glycogen store is finished, and then
So it has got an anabolic, it has got an anabolic as well as catabolic function. The liver deals in anabolism as well as catabolism of these substances, of these proteins, fats, and carbohydrates. Right? Okay. So let me complete your this thing. Then proteins, we see that whatever proteins we eat, isn't it? Then proteins which are broken down, the proteins are broken down in the intestine, they are broken down into amino acids. And these amino acids, they go into the liver. And in the liver, these amino acids are utilized to form different enzymes and again to form the proteins, to send these amino acids or form enzymes there or form some other proteins. And these amino acids can also then go from, once they are go to the liver, then and these amino acids can also go to the cells where they are used for building the muscles. You understand? Yes. What is the effect on the fat?
In the fat metabolisms, the excess fat will be stored in the adipose tissue, and then will be broken down into glycerol and fatty acids and form lipoproteins, high density lipoproteins, low density lipoproteins, and circulate in the blood.
So you mean to say that whenever we eat the fats, right, these fats are broken down into fatty acids, and the fatty acids are then absorbed. You understand my point? And these fatty acids, they reach to liver. You got my point? And once they reach to liver, they are again the you see, the fat is basically triglycerides. We call them as triglycerides. You understand my point? And these triglycerides are broken down to fatty acids. So they are broken down to free fatty acids and glycerol. So this action is being done in the intestine, and this action is also being done in the liver, right? So in the liver, they are again formed into triglycerides, they assemble. You understand my point? And now once these triglycerides are formed, so triglyceride is a fat. You understand my point? And who will send this fat to the cells? So there are certain other substances, what is called as chylomicrons, they act like trucks, like the carrier trucks. So they carry these triglycerides, they carry the other fats like cholesterol, right? And through these chylomicrons, the chylomicrons take them to the different cells of the body. And once these triglycerides reach there, the triglycerides are getting unloaded. All these fatty acids are getting unloaded, and they are being unloaded to different tissues of the body, different cells of the body, where they are used for different functions of the body, like forming the cell wall, because we know the cell wall is lipid, this thing, and then they are used as fuel so that the energy is produced for different activities of the body. So it is the chylomicrons which carry this fat to different tissues of the body. Chylomicrons, they act as the trucks, carrier trucks. And once they unload, the chylomicrons again come back into the liver and they are being reutilized. It is in the simpler form I am telling you what is the role of liver as far as proteins, fats and carbohydrates are concerned. So the liver forms, the liver uses these proteins to form the enzymes, because for different actions of the body we need enzymes. For different actions of the cells we need enzymes. Like we got so many enzymes in the body, isn't it? They are all formed from the proteins. Okay, done. Thank you.